There's another condition that is interesting. It's called frozen shoulder. What is that?
So frozen shoulder is a term that is kind of heard of a lot these days. The actual medical term for frozen shoulder is adhesive capsulitis.
We have a visual there, if you could explain it to us.
Yeah, so basically if you see the white overlay that's being displayed in that area there by the humerus, and you see the red area kind of displaying where there's been irritation, that outside area is called the joint capsule. And that joint capsule is the outermost layer of soft tissue. So it kind of surrounds the ligaments, the muscles, and everything. So it's the most outer layer of the shoulder complex there. And what happens is that joint capsule shrivels and starts stiffening. And then it goes through a process from there where the patient begins to lose range of motion and mobility in the shoulder, and it's associated with a lot of pain. And this is one of the conditions that we see a lot at the clinic, and it's a very frustrating type of condition to treat because it requires a lot of patience on both the part of the clinician and of the patient, because there's a period of time that is associated with this type of injury. Luckily, this type of injury is a self-limiting injury, meaning over a period of time, this injury will improve on its own, but there's still research and debate whether or not interventions from a medical standpoint, like physical therapy, are helpful or not. From a personal opinion, what I've seen at the clinic is it is helpful in trying to speed up the process of healing with frozen shoulder. One of the common things with frozen shoulder, it's more prevalent in women. And usually in middle-aged women, so women above the age of 40. And then there's no specific reason that they've been able to find why this occurs, but many times one of the predisposing factors is a previous injury. So, for example, someone had surgery for the shoulder, and they're recovering from the shoulder, and unfortunately they have to be immobilized just to let the shoulder heal after surgery. This can lead to frozen shoulder-type presentation from that patient. Another risk factor is diabetes. That's been associated with frozen shoulder. But usually there's not a specific event that the person can pinpoint of, why this started occurring. So it's a pretty frustrating type of injury, to be honest with you.